Can you see why this picture of Trump on Air Force One yesterday has so many liberals upset? President Trump knows how to tweak liberals and their delicate sensibilities and is quite successful at it, too. Just when the leftists think they have the upper hand on Trump, he ends up masterfully changing their narrative and foiling their plans. We have witnessed President Trump's tactics as he uses Twitter to convey his message to his supporters on his plans to make America great again. So, the day after the election on Tuesday, Trump took to Twitter to send a message to Americans across the country, and of course it had liberals raging mad. It does not take much to frustrate liberals. All anyone has to do to win a debate against a leftist is bring facts and logic to the table, and typically they will melt away like snow on a warm day. As liberals are dancing in the street celebrating what they are calling an epic win on Tuesday night, President Trump sucked the wind out of their sails with this amazing tweet. Yesterday marked the one-year anniversary that President Trump shocked the political world by soundly defeating Hillary Clinton in the 2016 presidential race. The day after Trump won the election, the mainstream media puppets were in shock and stunned, realizing that Queen Hillary Clinton lost the election yet again. The left quickly dissolved into tears. Images of faithful Hillary supporters in fetal positions were uploaded onto social media, and protests broke out across the country. For the left, last year at this time was their darkest day, but for conservatives, it was a beacon of hope that we could finally change the course of our country. President Trump also has not forgotten how impressive his win against Hillary Clinton was and congratulated all of us for rocking the vote in 2016. Here is more from Washington Examiner. President Trump marked the one-year anniversary of his election by thanking the deplorables who contributed to his Electoral College landslide victory. Congratulations to all of the deplorables and the millions of people who gave us a massive, 304-227, Electoral College landslide victory. Trump tweeted, along with a photo of him and his top aides aboard Air Force One flashing thumbs-up signs for the camera. Included in the photo with Trump are White House Communications Director Hope Hicks, White House Senior Advisor Stephen Miller, White House Senior Advisor and the President's son-in-law Jared Kushner, personal aide and special assistant to the President John McEntee, and White House Social Media Director Dan Scavino. The President is currently in China as part of a 13-day trip to Asia. Trump has already visited Japan and South Korea as part of the trip, and will also travel to Vietnam and the Philippines. Trump defeated Democratic presidential nominee Hillary Clinton on November 8, 2016. Since then, the president has frequently invoked his electoral win over Clinton, who won the popular vote by more than 2.8 million votes. Now, no one is saying that the election results on Tuesday were not a sober reminder of what work still needs to be done for the 2018 midterm elections. But it was also a day to celebrate. When Donald Trump announced his presidential bid, the mainstream media, liberals, and even some Republicans scoffed at the very notion of a Trump presidency. As the election grew closer and the reality that Trump could win frightened the political establishment and their panic set in. When Trump beat Hillary Clinton, it sent shockwaves throughout the Beltway as they realized their reign of power was over. The win was a referendum to liberal leaders that they no longer wanted the status quo and were blatantly rejecting the socialist ideology. Now, after a year, the country has become even more divided as these liberal pundits have been busy fanning the flames of division and demonizing President Trump and his supporters. While the wins on Tuesday were not entirely unexpected, it does send a reminder to all those who plan on running in 2018 that they need to get their act together. The reason that Trump won last year was that he tapped into what the American people were saying and listened to them. The American people are sick and tired of business as usual, and if they do not see the Republicans in the House and Senate start playing tough ball, they will stay home. President Trump's huge win last year was unprecedented, and it would be a shame to let that historic win fall to the wayside by allowing rhinos to stay in office. This is our time to take our country back from the liberal progressives who have been ruining it for the last 8 years, and we cannot let President Trump down.